40% of Americans who are earning $100,000 or above are living paycheck to paycheck in the United States. In a recently released report, Lending Club Bank reported some very shocking numbers that 54% of America across a broad spectrum of income and age are living paycheck to paycheck in America. We are surviving a pandemic, but this report exposes a financial pandemic amongst a majority of Americans. A lot of people are truly on the financial edge of life. People today are spending all of what they earn. For a complex set of reasons, results show that many people are not saving for retirement nor a better future. Hi, Jeff here, where I believe better finance equals a better life. Please join me on my journey to financial freedom, where I hope to pass on some important things I learned about wealth from my mentors. And please like and subscribe if you feel inclined. Back to the report, 54% of consumers, or 125 million people in the US, are living paycheck to paycheck. This is a staggering number that unveils the shaky financial foundation for a lot of people. In that 54% living paycheck to paycheck, 21% of this population struggle to pay their bills. This means that they have little or no money left over after spending their income. Overall, the report noted that consumers can have good incomes and college degrees, but still have very little left over after the cost of living. Breaking down by income, 39.3% of workers that make $100,000 or greater are living paycheck to paycheck. I'm sure that number of close to 40% comes as a shock to most people. Given by most people's standards, making $100,000 or greater is a good living. The 39% number is a total of two variables: those who live paycheck to paycheck and those who live paycheck to paycheck and struggle to pay their bills. For those who make 50 to 100K, 53% live paycheck to paycheck, adding up the top two lines. And then there are those who make less than 50K, with 71.7% living paycheck to paycheck. The less you make correlates with a higher percentage for those living paycheck to paycheck. Parsing these brackets out even more, for those making 100K or above, 12% struggle to pay their bills every month. In the 50 to 100K bracket, 18% struggle to pay their bills. And finally, those that are making less than 50K, 33% struggle to pay their bills every month. The bottom line in this report is that more than half of the Americans in this country are spending just as much as they're earning. This is a recipe for disaster, whether they know it or not, which will have dire consequences in their later lives. There's very little doubt when the pandemic hit, job losses threw a monkey wrench in most people's finances. The stimulus checks that went out helped plug those holes for many people. As a positive sign, a year into the pandemic, the struggling paycheck-to-paycheck consumer increased their savings threefold to $6,200. In March of 2020, before the pandemic, the average savings was a meager $2,400. The study also found that the biggest generation in our country, the millennials, have the highest percentage of living paycheck to paycheck at 70%. Given this, we also see the millennials have the highest percentage for those struggling to pay their bills at 33%. This would make sense because millennials are in their peak spending years, starting families and purchasing homes. Many also have to contend with large amounts of student debt. The overarching question is, why are so many people over all income and education levels living paycheck to paycheck? Is life in the information age so expensive these days that we can barely make ends meet? Everyone's situation is dynamic and different. There are many external and internal forces that make for people living paycheck to paycheck. However, I can't help but be reminded that most of us in America are not taught financial education. We see evidence of this as 50% of America do not invest. We learn everything important in life, from the sciences to literature, but the one essential skill set that we need to survive after we get out of school, and that is personal finance. If you think about it, we take driver's education classes in preparation to safely drive a car. However, many people are never taught personal finance, budgeting, or investing before we enter the real world of earning a living. Is it no wonder that many people are headed for a financial crash? Why have we not taught personal finance in our education system so all of us can drive to a better future? Another contributing force for those living paycheck to paycheck is the ever-increasing housing costs today. Homeowners are desperately stretching their dollars to own that piece of the American dream. If you're curious on why housing is so expensive these days, check out my two videos up there after this one. Median house price appreciation year over year has broken all records with a 20%+ increase. This year over year house appreciation is unprecedented. I doubt most workers in America are getting double digit salary increases to keep up with the 20%+ in housing costs today. And at the same time, our consumer society constantly bombards us with new products and gadgets to buy. With all the ads of living your best life today, companies and corporations seduce us out of our hard-earned wages. Due to many people's lack of financial education, do we not succumb to our desires more easily? Student debt is another big issue for those who took out hefty loans in the hopes of getting a step up in life. I wonder, if students were more financially literate, would they have taken out those hefty loans knowing the weight that it would bear on their lives? Also, college education has gotten more expensive than ever. Per Scott Galloway, the famous NYU professor, the rising cost of college has increased a whopping 1,400% in the past 40 years. How can average incomes keep up? It's no wonder that many people with families are living paycheck to paycheck. From my personal experience, my brother is now forking out $35,000 per year for his son to attend a good high school. When did high school become so expensive? Lifestyle inflation is also another key factor that needs to be addressed. Lifestyle inflation comes when your income goes up, but so does your lifestyle. It's the classic keep up with the Joneses mentality. Fortunately, this factor can be under our control. The occasional expensive dinner or drinks with friends seems harmless at first, until it becomes a weekly habit. Believing all things are connected, the lack of financial education in our lives can contribute to this lifestyle inflation. We're simply not taught to save for the future, nor live below our means. This way of living, when your standards goes up with your paychecks, can have bad consequences when there is a bump in the road in our lives. And as we all know, life gives us surprises that we just don't anticipate. In addition, we also have the ill effects of inflation itself that stretches our dollars. In 2020 alone, we have printed 20%, or a fifth, of all US dollars in the system, essentially flooding the economy with more money. The massive amount of money printing and stimulus checks helped out a lot of people during the pandemic, but it can also have very bad consequences. It creates a scenario where our dollars have less purchasing power to pay for everyday goods. In 2021, we've had record-breaking inflation where consumer goods and the cost of living has increased the fastest rate in years. The money printing is also why you see record gains in the stock and housing market, dividing the haves and have-nots even more. In the end, there are price hikes in life that none of us can avoid, but there are things we can do to save for a better tomorrow. Financial education is part of the solution to avoid living a lifestyle of paycheck to paycheck. If you got some value out of this, help me out with a like and subscribe. And for those who want to take a deeper dive into wealth and personal finance, check out my other videos on real estate and wealth building, and I'll see you on the next one.